Hello, beautiful souls. This is Julie with Into Heartspace, and we're looking at the energy surrounding April. And before I get into the personal sign readings, I'm going to do the collective one card pull. The one card that crosses boundaries. Everyone will feel in some way through April. And if you're not interested in this, then I have linked below a timestamp where the individual sign readings begin. But if you're still here, first and foremost, I apologize about my voice. I have bronchitis, and I've been going in and out of losing my voice, so I sound a little raspy, and if that annoys you, I apologize, and I hope and I'm sure that I will be much better by the next round of readings. Okay. Let's call in the highest of light, the highest of energy to guide us on this reading. What is the collective energy? What one card will resonate with everyone who watches this video? This one. Manifestation power. Ooh, yes, I love it. And you know why I really love this card too? Is because we're falling upon Aries season. So this is the beginning of the zodiac. It's kind of like, it's a new year. It's a new energy. Aries is moving forward. It's the first sign of the zodiac. And so we're coming into a new cycle of being. And so this is manifesting everything that you have been working for. As the card says, use your spiritual gifts and natural abilities to attract your desired outcome. So use what you're good at. Use what you know. Use your intuition. Use what is easy to you, which just comes naturally, to drive you forward, to push you into new boundaries, to manifest your power. And on to the reading we go. Hello, Taurus. This is Julie with Into Heartspace. And we're here looking at the energy surrounding you for April 2017. If you would like a personal reading, find me on Facebook, email me, or go to my website. Also, make sure to watch your moon and your rising sign, and if you're not sure what those are, in the description box below, I have provided a link for you to go to, and they will make your natal chart for you, and you can see all the planets and where they were at the time of your birth. Let's get into your reading. April 2017. What are the energies surrounding Taurus for April 2017? What messages do you have for Taurus? What energies, messages, guidance? Spirit says, keep going. They did the same thing to me on Leo's. I just did Leo's reading, and they just, Spirit wanted me to shuffle forever. All right, Taurus. And while I'm shuffling, if you're watching, then pay attention to the cards that are popping up and see what it kind of brings up for you, too. One, two, three, four. Okay. And the energy that's coming in from March is the Four of Wands. So this is a celebratory card. Things are going, things were panning out for you in March. You know, you were starting to see, the happiness, the happy side of situations, and you were able to connect with friends and family, and it just made you feel really comfortable and content with your life and those in it. And then we have the Knight of Cups. So for some of you, I do get the sense of maybe you might be getting proposed to, actually, Taurus. in April. We have the Unconscious, Justice reversed, King of Cups, Queen of Discs reversed, Knight of Swords, Ten of Cups reversed, Page of Swords reversed, Page of Wands reversed, Eight of Swords. I'm sorry, and the Page of Wands was not reversed. So, and then we have Strength reversed, Five of Cups, and Ten of Discs. Okay, reversed. The Ten of Discs is reversed. There are so many people in your reading. There's so much going on with different people in different fractions of your life. Like I was saying before, like some of you might have been getting proposed to, and it could have come out of the blue, and you're not 100% sure about the situation, but it was very sweet. It was very loving and romantic. It could also be that just somebody asked you out, or is going to ask you out in April, or wants you to move in, or move things along. So having this Knight of Cups is an offer of love, and it could be because you guys had been celebrating together in March, and things were just going so well in March. Why not continue it and up the ante a bit? Now, in the relationship area, we do have the Hanged Man, which is the Unconscious in this deck, reversed, and Justice reversed. And then we have the King of Cups. So Taurus, you could be dating or married to or connecting with a water sign. So that's Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. But having these two cards in reverse, having the Unconscious reversed is really not listening to your intuition, not listening to your guides, the universe, and what is going on. You keep questioning situations, keep questioning people that are being brought in. And even though this person, this King of Cups, is in their upright, you're leery. You're leery of them. And and it makes sense because you just don't feel like you can make good decisions right now. Like you're just not in the space to make really good decisions. Because you don't feel financially stable, you don't feel like you're in the right space, you know, like there's some things to do with possibly a lawsuit, possibly a divorce, that are popping up that you have to take care of, and you haven't taken care of them yet, or you're in the midst of it, and you're not liking the outcome of it. So having that here, having the Justice card reversed and the Unconscious is really a feeling of second guessing, a feeling of not feeling connected to yourself, unhinged a little bit, Taurus. Like, whatever decision you make will be wrong. But that's not true, okay? But that's what you're working through. And so there's this person who's coming in or who is in your life, water sign, who is awesome and fabulous for you. And I don't know what you're doing, but this King of Cups is here to help, here to assist you. And I think you're not allowing them to help you out because you don't know how to take them in. You don't know how to perceive them. You don't know what their true intention, and their true intention is just to be them. And they care about you, and they want to help you out, and it's that simple to them. But you're like, what's your ulterior motive? Taurus is like, oh, what do you really want from me? And they're like, I just want to be with you, really. And this could be lover, friend, family. And they could be the one who's offering you the cup, saying, hey, I love you, and I just want to help you out. And you're like, hell no, I know there's something more to it. Well, Taurus, they're telling the truth. And you can feel it because you feel calm when they say that. In work, we have the Queen of Discs reversed. And the Knight of Swords. And then the Ten of Cups reversed. So Spirit says that you are actually the Queen of Discs in reverse when it comes to work. And so in your job, in what you're doing right now, you are very skilled at it. You're amazing at it, actually. You're like top notch. Like anyone would be lucky to have you. But you're bored. You're bored, and you just don't think that what you're doing is really going to make you happy. It's not leading you to the life you want. Now, this Knight of Swords here can go either way. There's two different paths that this Knight of Swords can take. Is that this is your boss. This is somebody who looks over your job. And they're saying, you know what? I know you're awesome. I think you are so talented. You are gifted at your craft. But you've got to shape up, because you are just bringing everyone down and in this really depressing way. And you're not intending to, because you think you're like just keeping the status quo and keeping everything going. But you are so good at your job that when you just do it like even just slightly above average, that's not you. Like, you're always spectacular. You're always on it. And for you to just be doing what you're supposed to be doing and just a little extra instead of like your superstar rock star self makes people go, what are you doing? Why are you slacking? When other people do what you do and they're like, good job. Like, when you're slacking is somebody's best, right? But it's because you're like, I'm burnt out. I am so burnt out. I have been burning the candle on both ends. I'm burnt out. And I can't even give my best right now, because it's not my best right now is what I'm giving. So having this Ten of Cups is asking you, is this where you want to go? Is this the life you want? And if it is, then you need to rest and up the ante and find balance and find your emotional, find love in your heart for what you're doing. But if you're like, no, I'm burnt out and I need to move on, then you definitely need to do that. Now, so this Knight of Swords, I only gave you one of the options. The second one was that it's an offer coming in and it's really quick and they're like, take it or leave it. You have like 2 seconds, yes or no. You know, and so you have to be ready to decide when this comes in April. If somebody comes and says, hey, do you want to work for me? I need to know by the end of the day. You need to be very clear about it and be like, yep, yeah, I definitely do. Or nope, I'm going to work through this, you know. Okay. And then in abundance, we have the Page of Swords. I'm sorry, the Page of Swords. I was right. In reverse, Page of Wands, and then the Eight of Swords. So there more people. This is young energy. One is a fire energy, so that's Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and then the Swords energy is air sign, so that's Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Now the Wand sign is upright, and the Page of Swords is in reverse. So I know that the fire sign is working from a true foundation. It's working from truth and honesty of self. And that the Page of Swords is working from a manipulative situation, trying to get what they want at any cost. Now, with the Eight of Swords there, it's really saying you don't see either side of this. And this is your abundance. So I think... Yeah, Spirit is saying that these aren't necessarily people, but aspects of self. So the Page of Swords is that you're not speaking up for yourself and for your worth. You're not speaking up and you're just letting people kind of walk over you, Taurus, and going along with it just because that's easier. Having the Page of Swords in reverse is just being like tongue-tied, not being able to communicate and not feeling like your worth is there, or not necessarily that your worth is there, but it's just not worth saying. But then we have the Page of Wands aspect, and that is this bright light, this vibrancy, this youth-like humor, funny, and giving and warm. But it, remember, this is in a juvenile state. This is still very young and still growing within you. And so the Eight of Swords is feeling blocked out of both sides, blocked by both sides. So you're unable to communicate, unable to stand up for yourself and say what you want to say. But you have this feeling of youth and buoyancy, but you don't know how to get it across and you don't know what to do with it. So with this abundance, it's like take off the mask, shimmy out of the bondage, the self-made bondage, and embrace your joy, your humor, your life, and speak about it. It's worth, we need to hear it. That's where your abundance will come, is once you are able to communicate who you are in a way that is honest and true to you, things will start to shift. And the thing is I say that things will start to shift. Things are really shifting, you know, like you're getting these offers from different aspects that are here to push you along, to raise you up, to help you find yourself, to help you believe in yourself and trust your own spirit. But you have to, you know, get out of your own self-made bondage first. And it could be, I mean, these it could also be people. So it could be somebody in your life has really been negative and saying, you can't do it. You're not good enough. You don't know what you're doing. You should stop now. And listen to me on this too, okay? This person could be manipulating you by saying positive things, okay? So let's say you're in a situation with a friend, because this would be, for a lot of you, a friend, and you're saying, hey, you know what? I really want to take up skydiving. I think I'm going to be awesome at it. I could teach people how to do it. And your friend's like, oh, skydiving, that's so amazing. I mean, being up so high and just like letting go. And do you think you really could do that? That's so terrifying. How much money is it? Oh, I'm sure you'll come up with it. Oh, do you think you could like die from that? But you know, I'm sure you won't die from that. You know, so do you hear kind of how that happened? Is like, it sounds like they're supporting you, but they're placing doubt within everything you're doing or with what you're thinking. They're like giving you all of this shade through it seems like positive reinforcement. So pay attention to some friends who are doing that, who are like, oh, that is so amazing. Do you think you really could do that? Like, listen to that juxtaposition there. Now, but you also have a dear friend who could be just very, really youthful and funny and fun and just makes you feel great, okay? And they could be really, they could have a lot of fiery aspects. Like they could actually be really beautiful and, but beautiful in heart and beautiful mind and beautiful in body too. And you just like being around them. It feels warm being around them. You don't get that shade from them. So hang out more with a fire sign than with an air sign in April. Okay. And then in mind, body, soul, we have strength reversed, which is, you know, obviously not believing in yourself. And it's also, you're not believing in yourself because you feel like you've messed up so many times. How could you possibly, you know, do right now? I will never have joy and happiness in my life. I should just give up now. No, absolutely not. That's silly. That is silly, 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 Taurus. Don't give up now. There's still two cups behind you. You only have two hands. You can't hold three. Well, if you're a server, you can. But that's just skills. But what I'm saying is there's plenty. There is plenty there. And don't be selfish about it, you know? Don't be like, I want all five. No, you don't need all five. You can't use all five. You have two cups behind you waiting for you, and that could be people, and that could be also a new job, that could be a new place to live, a new friend, a new love, a new car. I don't know. I just said new car because it felt like I should say that. But it is. It's like this self-defeating attitude is what is ruining your body, mind, and spirit. So you also might be drinking too much. Some people might be exercising too much too. And I get this from lack of strength, actually. Sometimes when we have the strength reversed, people go into overdrive. And then they're like, I've got to work out every day for the rest of my life. That's the only thing I can do. I'm not strong enough. I need to get stronger. So then they overdo it, and then they get injured, and then they can't work out, and then it starts to cycle over again. I'm like, I'll never be happy until I'm this. I'll never be happy until I weigh that. I'll never be happy until I can do 500 push-ups kind of thing. And so universe goes, really? And then like slaps your hand, knocks you down, and says, find happiness now. Because it's all around you. Okay. So let's actually pull on the animal spirit knowledge cards. So this is going to be the animal to focus on through April. These popped out. I'm not going to accept it because there's a ton here. And it was my sloppy shuffling. Okay, what animal? Okay. So the one that kind of popped out is, let me see. Here you go. The raven. Sorry, there's a glare. Okay, so the raven is a symbol of creation, magic, and illumination. The raven is frequently associated with powerful magic and omens. Its symbolism parallels that of the coyote and the rabbit in Native American myths. It is worshipped as a deity. The Haida and the Tlingit people of Western Canada, sorry if I butchered that, and Alaska revered the raven as a hero and helper of human beings, a role reflected in the bird's prominent position in the totems of the Northeast. The raven is believed to have placed the sun, moon, and the stars in the sky, bringing light to the people both day and night. The painting of this raven amid the celestial bodies of the night sky recalls the Haida and the Tlingit legend. So, the raven in the night sky. Do you see the moon? And you can kind of see the stars speckled across and the setting sun below. So remember, the raven, creation, magic, illumination. And so going back to the beginning of the unconscious, the hanged man, in reverse, is asking you to find the magic within yourself, illuminate you, illuminate your strength and what you stand for and who you are and what is worth standing strong for. Acknowledge that, be clear about that, there's somebody there to love you. Also, once again, with illumination, what will make you happy? You are already gifted and crafted at what you do in work. What do you need to do to create your happiness in the future? You may be getting an offer. Will you take it? Is it what you need? Or are you going to stay where you are, push through, and find a new way of processing your job? Make sure to focus on love and joy in your life. There's somebody who's trying to bring you down, and there's somebody who's trying to lift you up. Now, this may not be people. This actually just may be you, contradicting yourself over and over again, conflicting, confusing you, and not allowing you to see which way is up. Stay strong. Strength takes time. It takes endurance. It takes consistency to build. You are not your past. You are now. You are who you are now. Okay. So, Taurus, If you would like a personal reading, go ahead and find me on Facebook, email me, or go to my website. And until next time, so much love, joy, and blessings.